Welcome to lesson 20, and this lesson will be about investments, performing operations with rational numbers. So we are going to be looking at a very real life operation, and that is this idea of investments, investing for your future. In this case, it'll be about college investments, something that's very real to all of our families, and hopefully you'll come out of this lesson understanding better the idea of a ledger or the transactions that take place. We call them either a register or a ledger. And I will go ahead and show you that right now, just so I can give you the kind of the ins and outs of that. If you've ever seen your mother or father's checkbook, for example, it's kind of a ledger of sorts. Most of us don't really do much with our checkbooks anymore, but those of us who do use it to keep a balance, to know exactly how much money we have at any given time in our checking account, for example. But we are going to work with a register, and let's go ahead and take a look at one right now. So if you turn to the third page in your binder for lesson 20, you will find this here. We're going to fill this in using the information that is provided, and I will model that first and help you with it. But for most of this ledger or register, you are going to be completing it yourself. Just to show you, let's just talk about all the different columns. Okay, so right here is first one. The first one, of course, is date. Very important. Now this this investment activity we're going to be doing, it works under the premise of receiving a statement every 6 months, as you can see, between January and June 2008, and then July and December 2008. That would be the two statements or two pieces of paper you would get to show you what exactly happened with your investment. And that varies from investment to investment. If you have a regular checking account or savings account, we usually get those monthly. But something such as this investment account, any kind of retirement account or such, usually get those in 6 month chunks. Okay, 6 months, or at least 3 months at times. So it does indeed vary. Okay, but anyway, that first column there is the date column. Next to that is a description of the transaction. Okay, this is what happens, what occurs, because the things that can occur is, as you can see in the next column, you can withdraw money, you can deposit money. All right, so now this description here, this may be, you know, withdrew money for college fees, because this is going to be a college investment, talking about a mom and dad trying to save up some money for their children or for the one child to go to college. And that is going to be our pursuit. You're going to find out if they're actually able to save enough money and save the money they want to have saved by the time she goes to school. But anyway, in this description of transaction, you would write actually usually to whom it goes to. It's like to whom and then for what, actually, is what. So to whom, for what. Okay, if this was a checkbook, you know, you might, mom might pay for, you know, some groceries. You know, you might be writing this check out to Save Mart, and it might be for groceries. Okay, so that's what would go in here. This description of transaction, always handy to have, just so you can see where the money is going and for what reason it's being spent. Withdrawal amount, is this is money that's coming out. This is a negative number. Okay, usually, you know, very often is in parentheses when it's a negative number. Now deposit is going to be money that went in, so we're looking at plus here or minus here. Okay, and then this is your running, always your running balance is right here. Okay, your running balance is always here. So when we look at this this register as it stands, all we have right now is the $20,000 balance, because that's the money that the mom and dad put in initially. Okay, they initially put in that $20,000. Now they're going to see their money work as an investment, because the investment's going to be earning interest as it sits in this account. Okay. Now the expression part of it is not something you would ever find in a register or ledger. This is just for our purposes. We're going to be, of course, applying this to the subtraction of rational numbers, addition or subtraction of rational numbers. Okay, so you're going to have to write an expression up here. There's no expression here because it was just simply money put in. Okay, $20,000 was deposited into this account. Okay, but here's what a register looks like, and it usually has those columns that can appear differently in different types of registers or different type of ledgers. Money that goes in is often, is your income. Money that goes out are your expenses, okay? And then your balance is, of course, your balance, which you have left over after either putting money in or taking money out. Okay, so here's our scenario now. Mathematical modeling exercise, college investments. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and read this scenario to you and then just kind of step out your task down here, and then we will begin it together. Okay, so Justin and Adrian deposited $20,000 into an investment account for 5 years. They hoped the money invested and the money made on their investment would amount to at least $30,000 to help pay for their daughter's college tuition and expenses. Now, I can tell you if they wanted to save money for 1 or 2 years, that's good, but I'm sure they're not going to be able to pay the entire college expense with just $30,000. But anyway, really good reason to do well in school and maybe get an academic scholarship. But let me just pull out some numbers here. So they deposited $20,000. Okay, that's what went in. They're going to keep it in this account for 5 years. So I guess their daughter must be, what would she be? Be an eighth grader then? Eighth grader, 5 years later, she'll be going into school, into college. They're trying to have at least $30,000 at the end of those 5 years. So that means they're trying to actually make a profit of $10,000 on this money. Okay. All right, which is quite a lofty goal, quite a lot, okay? Anyway, so let's go ahead and continue here. The account they chose has several benefits and fees associated with it, okay? So there are benefits, which means going to be interest that you can earn, and then fees, which are fees that you need to pay. So you're looking at some income and some expenses, some withdrawals and some deposits, right? And like we talked about already, every 6 months, a summary statement is sent to Justin and Adrian. The statement includes the amount of money either gained or lost. Okay, so they're going to actually get a statement, and that statement is going to have on there how much money they either gained or lost, and that's all based on what this money is invested in. I know this is probably very new to many of you, but when you invest in something of this nature, this money goes into maybe a couple of companies, bigger companies like Nike, maybe McDonald's, and several companies. I mean, there's hundreds of thousands of companies the world over, but it gets invested there. If those companies do well, their stock price goes up, and you make money. And then vice versa could happen as well. A company could be doing poorly for some reason. The economy could go south, which means could start performing poorly. We could invest in things like gold and silver and all kinds of investment possibilities. All right. So, but they're going to get a summary statement. Okay, this is a summary statement, which is actually going to give them the amount of money either gained or lost. Okay. There. And then below, not quite below, but on the next page, are semi-annual, okay, this idea of semi-annual means twice a year, statements for a period of 5 years. Okay, in addition to the statements, the following information is needed to complete the task. Okay, so for every statement, there is an administrative fee of $15. Okay, so that administrative fee needs to be entered into the register, or the ledger that we just talked about, okay, to cover costs for secretarial work, office supplies, postage, etc. And that is very real. Very often there are administrative fees that get applied to these investments. A second point here is if a withdrawal is made, a broker's fee is deducted from the account, okay? The amount of the broker's fee is 2% of the transaction amount, okay? So this does happen. You try to avoid investments like this, especially if they're college investments, because you'd like to have a be able to put money into an account that's not going to be loaded with fees. 2% may sound like very little, but the truth is it can add up, all right? So, for example, withdrawal, you understand what that means, withdrawal. So if you take money out, and the reason you would take money out is if you have expenses for something, okay? Truly, you don't usually withdraw until your child goes to college, and some of these investments, they're not allowed to actually withdraw any money until they are in college. But for our purposes here, and again, to demonstrate how taking a deduction of 2%, we will just, I guess, make believe. It's all make believe right now, but we'll make believe this is true. Okay. So, for example, if you took a withdrawal, let's just start with a very simple number. Okay, $100. Then this would mean 2% of $100, of course, is $2. So this this broker's fee then for a withdrawal of $100 would be $2. Okay, and that applies to to whatever amount it is. Okay, all right. So here's your task right here. Your task is using the above information, the semi-annual statements, which are on the next page, the register, which is on the page after that, and the beginning balance, which we saw was $20,000, you are to do the following. Okay, do the following. Record the beginning balance and all transactions from the account statements into the register. Okay, so you're going to need to record everything that you see that comes from the comes from all the account statements. You are going to determine the annual gain or loss, as well as the overall 5-year gain or loss. Okay, and I'll kind of step you through this stuff. So you're going to find an annual gain or loss. That's for every year, okay? Because sometimes you do lose money, okay? Sometimes because of the performance of the stock market, like I had told you, the economy in general, you will actually lose money in a given year. And that's the risky nature of investing. And it's just something that you have to live with if you want to invest. Some people don't. Some people just put their money and get very little interest in a savings account or other instruments. But if you're going to, if you want to try for a lot of money, you have to risk. Take some risks, okay? So you're going to determine an annual gain and loss as well as the overall 5-year gain and loss, okay? And what they want, their goal, is to get to this $10,000 gain, okay? And so here's the next one, kind of talks about that. So you're going to determine if there's enough money in the account, okay? Determine if there's enough money to cover $30,000 for college expenses for Justin and Adrienne's daughter, okay? You're going to write a summary at the end to defend your answer, which is going to be pretty straightforward. Be sure to indicate how much money is in excess, okay? This idea is how much money you have over, okay? In excess is over that $30,000, or shortage, okay? And a shortage is going to be under, okay? How much did they miss by? So it'll either be a, they'll either have an excess of money, that means more than $30,000, or they'll have a shortage, which will be under $30,000, okay? And then there's going to be some related questions that follow, all right? Sounds really, really complicated with all these new words that are being thrown at you, but if you can follow closely with me as I as I help you initially, I think you'll be able to do a good job with it but on your own. Okay, so let's take a look at these. These are all these semi-annual statements, okay? I'll take you through these. You can see here between January 1st, 2008 and June 30th, again, a six-month period, there was a gain. You could tell there's a gain because there are no parentheses around the number, okay? You have parentheses around a number, and we'll see that coming up. That means it is a loss, okay? So if there are no parentheses, that is a gain. So in this case, we have a gain. If you wanted to go ahead, maybe you could just like kind of circle these right now as we, and again, this is the second page in your binder, okay? So there's a gain of $700, okay? This might be a good way to start. if we look at the second statement, which is to the right of it, you can see there's another gain of $754.38. It's another gain, okay? And now you have to remember, because we'll do the first 6 months' entries together, but remember what they had said. What goes along with this now is there's always going to be this administrative fee, okay? Always have to apply that. So that's going to be a withdrawal, okay? A withdrawal of the $15, all right? Just so you remember that, okay? And here we go again, the next one, and this is the beginning of the next year, 2009, that first six-month statement. Now you can see there's a loss, okay, because it's been, it has parentheses around it. And that's what parentheses indicate when we're talking dollars and cents, and input and output. Okay, all right, and here we go down here, the second half of that 2009 year, there was the loss of $1,741, but also a withdrawal. They withdrew money right here, $500. Now you have to remember, with that withdrawal, you need to apply a broker's fee. So you're going to need to take 2% of that $500. And you're going to deduct it, okay? It's going to be a withdrawal on top of that. So you are often penalized money, okay? There's a penalty for withdrawing money from an account such as this early. When you withdraw money early on a college investment, you often tend, even an individual retirement account for any individual, if you take money out of this account, you are often penalized, okay? You're penalized a certain percentage, and you can see in this case it's always 2%. So you'll have to apply and take 2% of this $500, okay? And we'll calculate that together, but I guess we will when we correct it all. We'll do all that together, okay? All right, so here's the first statement of the 2010 year. And you can see now, back into the gaining ways. We've gained $676.93. Second half of that year, 2010, another gain, a little bit larger gain there. Another $49.45. Okay. Just trying to map all this out with you. So here we go, starting 2011 year. Okay, there was a deposit, okay, of $1,500, all right? So that's money that went in. You don't need to, there's no penalty on depositing money, so that money is going to be recorded as solely as a deposit, okay, money that goes in. You don't pay any penalty because you put money in. You don't, you'll get extra money because what that money will be doing, the money that you put into an account will earn money itself, okay? And then in this case, there was another net gain of $880.09. Okay, that second half of that year, 2011. Right there, there was another gain, $922.99. Now you can see how these, and again, it depends on the whole market conditions, but you see how this is going up. It's going to go up Basically, if things stay the same, because you have more money in that account, okay, there's more money in there. So there's a saying in investing, you know, it takes money to make money. So if you have money to put in, you can actually earn a lot more money. Okay, if you start with very little money, you don't earn as much. Okay, but you have to start somewhere, you know. So sometimes a little bit of money grows into more money, and then which grows into even more money after that. Okay, so the second half here of, the first half of 2012, right here, we have another deposit, okay, money going in, and then we have another gain of $940.33, okay, and then we have the last half of that year, and our last statement right there, we ended up with another final gain, $909.71. And if I'm saying these numbers wrong, I'm sorry, but we'll get it later because I can't see it too well. You don't understand. You can still see. Okay, so that's just a look at all of those statements. Each one of these you would have been received in a six month at the end of a 6 month period. Okay. So this one is usually received a little bit after that 6 month is over. So for example, this one goes until June 30th, 2008. You'd probably receive it in the mail sometime in July, okay? Because it usually comes after. But they're just trying to give you an idea of how your investment's doing, okay? So let's go ahead and apply. Let's start with this first month, and let's go ahead and fill out the first month of the register, okay? So here is that register, okay? Now you have right here, you have a beginning balance of $20,000, okay? I should put that in under the expression, but I really meant just to put it there for the, put it there for the balance, the beginning balance right there, okay? You have a beginning balance of $20,000. Now, what you do, therefore, is you want to, there's an expression that says, bring the balance forward, okay, which means you're going to bring your balance up here. So here's your beginning balance. Let's go ahead and put it right here. Okay, that's pretty much all this is for. And what that is the beginning. So the beginning of the period, how much money do you have in this account? So at the beginning of this January to June 2008 period, there is $20,000 in this investment, okay? Now, for this period, of course, I'm going to write in red. You guys don't have it for the withdrawals, but remember the withdrawal? We had a withdrawal of $15. This is going to happen every single six-month period, okay? A $15 fee. Remember the administrative fees, okay? We had no deposits, all right? There were no deposits. You don't need to put nothing, but you could put a little dash if you want to right there. Now, this balance right here, your balance is going to be, I just stopped that for a minute here. I just wanted to actually correct something. Let's go ahead and let's just take this off of here, okay? Now, in certain ledgers, like a checking account ledger, you would indeed continually bring that balance forward. We're not going to do that now because we're going to need all of these rows here to describe our transactions. Okay, so go ahead and just bear with me here. So, but the first thing we're going to do here is the first transaction we're going to talk about is that administration fee. Okay, so I'm just going to put admin. You guys could probably fit it in there, okay? So administration fee, and so that's going to go in your withdrawal column, okay? $15, all right? So, and again, you can have a calculator handy, and if you don't have one right now, stop this, pause this presentation and go ahead and grab one, okay? It'll be coming very handy, all right? So we're going to go ahead and, $20,000 take away $15 is 19,000, let's see, $985. Is that right? 15, blah, 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 yeah, I should know that. Yeah, so $19,985. That's your balance at this point. Now, this expression, this is going to get really annoying, but I would like you to do this continually, okay? Of course, the expression was 20,000 minus 15, and I'm not putting the dollars. If you want to put the decimal point and the two decimal zero, you can do that if you want to, but I am avoiding that right now, even though it is very important at times. Okay, so that was my administration fee. Now, I'm just going to put here, the next thing that happened during this period was a gain. Okay, and that's my gain on investment. Sometimes they call that ROI, which is return on investment. So that, I'm just going to put gain because it's takes up a lot less space. So what we made, if you notice that in that first statement, we gained, or they gained $700. Okay, and that's going to go in the deposit column. Okay, not that we are actually putting that money in, because we're not. Okay, we're not actually putting that $700 in. That money was just made by the investment. Okay, but we'll put it there anyway because it is it's a positive. Okay, so now $700, we're going to go ahead and add $700 now to our balance. Our running balance right now is $19,985. If we add $700, we're going to end up with $20,685, okay? And our expression, of course, here was $19,985 plus $700, okay? So that's what we did to get to that. So right now, our balance is right here, $20,685. That's how much is in their account right now. So they made a net gain of what, $685, because they started out with $20,000 and now they're up to that, and that's at the end of 6 months. Okay, so let's go ahead and do the next one. So we're going to move over to the next statement, which goes from July 1st, 2008 to December 31st, 2008. All right, I have to remember again, this is going to look very similar to the one we just did. But there's always that admin fee, okay? So you have the administration fee, and that is $15. Again, it's continually going to be put into that withdrawal column. All right, so now we're taking $15 off of this $20,685. So now we're at $20,670. And what I did was I took $20,685 and I subtracted away $15. Okay, all right, and that's my administrative fee. Then my deposit, I'm going to use the gain we had of $754.38. Okay, so $754.38, and let me go ahead and write a description here. Always remember the transaction description. That's another gain, okay, gain on investment. And then if we go ahead and you can see right now, I really wish I had my own calculator handy, but what's this going to be? So I got 38, oh, let me pause and figure it out. Okay, yeah, so it was $21,424.38, as you can see right there. This is getting really sloppy with my pen, my bulky pen. Hopefully yours will look a bit better. But the expression, of course, is taking $20,670, which was that balance prior, and then adding the $754.38. Now, again, with all these dollars and cents, it can get really, really sloppy. Okay, so double check your addition and your subtraction throughout. So what I'd like you to do, this is pretty straightforward. I'd like you to go ahead and complete this yourself. Let me just show you one item beforehand. Let's see, where do we first have two things? Now, just remember, actually, let's do the next one together. Let's go ahead and do this 6 month period right here, because it is a little bit different. Okay, a little bit different. So let's go ahead and do that one. Okay, so here we have for our next January to June 2009. We're right over here. Okay, our first thing, let's just go ahead and write that in, is our administrative fee. Okay, admin fee. Okay, again, 15. You guys, you know this one well. All right, take away 15 from here. 21,409.38. And you know what this expression is, blah, 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 blah. You write it in. I'm not going to, because my pen is just very, very big and bulky and annoying. Okay. All right, so now what's different, though, is now we have a loss. Okay, and again, I'm writing this in red just because I have that capability. But now I have a loss, okay? I had gains in my investment the prior two periods, but now there is a loss, a net loss, all right? So that loss is going to actually go in here to as a withdrawal, okay? And that was, what, $49.88, okay? $49.88. Now, another way to do this, let's just keep it this way. I won't say that. But anyway, yeah, $49.88 was our loss. So that means this has got to be actually subtracted again from our balance of $21,409.38. Okay, and that total is $21,374.50. So that's the balance at the end of that that 6 month period. Okay, so you can see what's happened. We are still, even though we've lost a little bit of money in there, and we continually are giving away these administrative fees. There's still a gain. Okay, they've actually gained. They've gone from what, 20,000 when they started, to $21,374.50 at this period. Okay, so they've made over $1,000, $1,300, almost $1,400, okay, over this period. A real hard thing, though, for people who invest make investments like this is when you see these statements continually and you watch your money go down as well, okay? It's not very happy to see your, for example, at the end of 2008, there was almost $50 more in the account than there is at this point right here. Okay, but anyway, you have to trust it when you're investing money in something like this. College, very, very important investment in your child's future. So anyway, go ahead and continue this. I would like you to do this yourself. All the way to the end, all right? And just finish completing this register first, and then I will come back and we will go over, I will have all mine plugged in and we can go over those and see what you ended up with. Might be a matter of just addition, subtraction. Please pay good attention to where you have a couple of different, as you can see right here, for example, in this, then the month coming up right now, you have the withdrawal of $500. You also have the withdrawal fee of that 2% of that $500 you have to pay, okay? And you have another loss here, okay? So there's going to be a bunch of withdrawing, okay? You're going to be pretty much stuck in that withdrawal column there, okay? So pay good attention to that one. Actually, why don't I pause right now? You pause. Do that month, complete that month, and check it before you go on, okay? Okay, I'm sorry, I have to show you something first. I made a little bit of a mistake, and that was due to my poor eyesight, and I didn't have my calculator nearby, so I was actually taking a look on my little cheat sheet here. But way back when, over here, when we took out that $49.88, that should have been the total. So at the end of this January to June 2009, we should have been at this amount here, $21,359.50. I think I had $21,374.50, something like that. So I was off. So Yeah, so okay, if you hopefully you got to this point anyway, but you might not have if you were following my numbers. If you were doing your own arithmetic, you probably had the right answer, and if you had a calculator handy. But anyway, yeah, so it just I just wanted to show you these different transactions. Okay, so we started with that. We started right here. This is where we should have started our balance at that point. There was an administrative fee to take off, as we know, the $15 here. That loss also, as we've done already, came off here as well. Now, something new was this withdrawal. So we actually took out, or they took out, $500 from the account. Okay, that had to come directly off of the balance. And then we had to calculate the fee. Okay, and that fee was, and I'm just going to write it down real quickly, it was $500. And then we had to take 2% of it off. And of course, that is times 0.02. Okay, if you do all this here, you know that that is actually going to be just $10. All right, $10. Quick way for me is I know that 10% of 500 is $50. So that means 20% is $100. So it just makes sense that 2% would be $10. Okay, the way I look at it. All right, and that's what we had to do. We actually had to calculate that 2%. So this withdrawal fee comes directly from that withdrawal, okay? And that had to be taken. So you can see in that period, this period of time here, everything was a withdrawal. So at this point now, while they're still ahead in their investment, they are kind of moving, it looks like they're moving backwards, okay? You really, really try when you're investing in something like this not to take money out, not to withdraw money, because you will incur a fee, and it just sets you back in your goals. Okay, so now go ahead, and I'd like you to go ahead and complete this register yourself. Again, going back to the statements and taking the numbers from there and plugging them in over into the register, and when you come back to this, just don't turn this back on until you get to the very end and you finish with that last statement. Whew, boy, that took a long time. You guys don't realize how long I was gone, but anyway, here is what I come up with at the end of that last statement, July through December 2012. The number I have here is $28,118.59. Okay, it doesn't look like they have reached their goal at this point. The goal was to be at $30,000. You know, the hopefully, again, something like this, honestly, if you ask your mom or dad or someone else about balancing a checkbook, for example, it is not an easy task, okay? There's a lot of things that can go wrong. So if you just notice some of these things, don't check every single entry here, but if you look at the last entry for every six-month period right here, you could check that one, see if that one matches mine. If that one matches mine, and again, you know how reliable I am, but if that one matches mine, if that one matches mine. So these are the last balance during that period, and then this that one there, and then this one right here. So if you check all of those, maybe you can see where something might have gone wrong. Believe me, incredible bear of a task is balancing checkbooks like this, but a very, very, very much a real-world assignment, okay? Just thought I would take just a quick moment, just the one aspect of this that maybe gave you a little bit of trouble, maybe not, was this idea of the broker fee that you had to pay when money was withdrawn. And we only had one withdrawal, thankfully, and that was $500. Okay, so if we were going to go ahead and find out what 2% of $500 was, again, 2% of, and we know that word of means multiplication, we would then just, for ease, we could change that 2%, we could change it to a fraction, which is 2 over 100, we could multiply that by 500 over 1. And if we went ahead and did our little cross-canceling, that would be 5, that would be 1. 2 times 5 equals 10 over 1, and then we know we have $10, okay? So that is a good way to do it by hand, arithmetically. You could, of course, punched in 500 and then the multiplication sign and then 0.02, and then you can get the, and then equals, or you can do it long, longhand. But that is 2% as a decimal. That is 2% as a fraction, and then as a percent, there it is right there. Okay? Okay, so the next thing we want to do with our register, we want to go ahead. This is what is part of our task. Overall task here is to find a total gain or loss per year. And again, of course, as we're learning this, is going ahead and applying and just showing a numerical expression. And in fact, we're going to actually use that numerical expression first, okay? Because if we're trying to find, just to show you a gain or loss, here's what you need to do. You need to actually take where you ended up. So in 2008, we ended up with 20,000... let's see, 21,000 here, right here. So we ended up 2008. Here's the end of 2008 right here. So we ended up at, here's our final balance, was 21,424.38. So we're going to go ahead and put that in here. 21,424.38. Okay. And then we're going to subtract from that, we're going to subtract our beginning balance. And of course, we know our beginning balance was right here, which was 20,000, okay? Minus 20,000, and if you go ahead, this is the easy one. If you go ahead and do that, you'll find out that our total gain, their total gain this year was $1,424. $424.38. Okay, so that's the total gain for the 2008 year. Okay, so that is what they gained by what they put into it, how the investment grew. Okay, now 2009, it's a little bit different because now what you do is you carry this part of this expression right here, and you're going to put that here because you're going to subtract that away because that's where you began over here. And now you want to take where you ended over here. So if we go ahead and look back at our register and we find the end of 2009, which is right here, okay, that's $20,817.09. $28,17.09. Okay, and if we went and subtracted that, so if we're going to subtract a larger number like this from a smaller number here, we were of course going to have a negative number, okay? And so if you go ahead and do that, you can actually punch this into your calculator this way, and it'll give you a negative sign in front of it. Or you know how you can do this. You just take the absolute value of these two, and then of course we're going to apply a negative sign. Okay, so this is going to be, then I'm going to put this in red, and to show that it is a negative value, I'm going to put parentheses around it, $607.29, okay, all right, or you could put a negative sign in front of it if you wanted to, but in terms of a register or anything like that, you use those parentheses, okay. So I'm just going to give you one more starting point here, just to let you know that, of course, this number here is going to go over here now, and then you're going to go ahead and find the rest of this. So what I want to do at the end is I want to see what you have for each subsequent total gain loss, and then go ahead and calculate a 5-year gain loss, and give me the numerical expression for calculating that 5-year gain or loss, okay? And come on back and check it. Okay, so here we are again. We are back, and hopefully you came up with all these numbers. If you didn't, just go back and check. Again, you're always, just always to remember, you're always taking this amount that you you start with, and then that's going to be your, be over here. It's always going to continue that way. As you can see, this number here, then it was over here, okay, because you're trying to find out the difference between what you end up with and what you had at the beginning, okay? And if you can see, you can just match your numbers to all of these. Our biggest gain year here was this one right here, 2011. Well, they put a good chunk of money in there. I think that's the year they put that $1,500 and they made a deposit, okay? And sometimes people will do that just to, get the fund performing. Well, anyway, at the end of it all, you had a five-year, or they had a five-year gain of $8,118.59. And, of course, you arrive at that by comparing the number you end up with, which was right here, and the number you began with, which was right here, began with $20,000. So before we go ahead and write a summary of our findings, you know, in those... because the question, one of our tasks that was put forth to us was to see if they actually made their goal. As you can see, they did not. Goal was 30,000. Ended up with a final balance of $28,118.59. Okay, but I wanted just to talk to you about how you went ahead and added all of these numbers here. These gains and losses. So a good way to do that, of course, is, I mean, you could do it on a calculator, punch in, you know, 1424.38, and then just subtract this, and then keep adding using the plus sign, okay? Or if you were going to do this by hand, just adding all of these positive figures up, actually not that one, add all the positive figures up, and then subtract away, finally, subtract away the negative 607.29. So yeah, in summary, if you're going to write up a summary for this project we did, we would say, since the beginning balance is, since the ending balance is less than $30,000, $30,000, and I really, really, really do apologize, it's really messy. $30,000, they will not have enough for their college expenses. They will not be able to cover the expenses, okay? All right, so something would have to be done, therefore, to achieve this goal. In fact, we needed to actually come up with a shortage amount, actually, because there was no extra. There was a shortage. And the way, of course, we figure out our shortage is to go ahead and take that $30,000 goal right here, and then we're going to subtract away our ending balance, which was this. So if we take $30,000 and subtract $28,118.59, we would come up with a shortage of $1,881.41. Okay, so we are left with this, or they were left, or would have been left with a shortage of $1,881.41. Okay, so now here are some what they're calling related questions, and you're going to need to apply the data that we just used or compiled to answer these questions. Now, this first one, I'm going to read it, and I'm hoping some of you might know how to actually write this out, and what kind of expression, or actually be writing an equation here. for this one right here. So it says here, for the first half of, this comes from our the example we just did, for the first half of 2009, there was a $700 gain on the initial investment of $20,000. So what they want you to do right now is to represent the gain as a percentage of the initial investment, okay? They want you to represent this as a percentage of the initial investment. So I think for, you know, for many of you, you might be scratching your head right now. But an easy way to do this, to accomplish this, is to write an equation with two balanced sides, okay? And the one side is going to actually contain this $700, okay? Because that's what we gained. And then the $20,000 is what they began with, okay? So 700 over 20,000, okay? So you are trying to represent the gain as a percentage. We are going to start with a fraction, okay? So we have a fraction here, okay? Because 700 out of 20,000, that's what we're trying to find out. Now, this is going to be equal to what we don't know. We don't actually know this top part, but it's going to be x over 100. Now, where does that x over 100 come from? That x over 100 is going to represent a percent, okay? Because we always write a percent. If we're going to write, we talked about this earlier in this lesson, if we're going to write a percent as a fraction, it's going to be the number over 100. Because you remember before when we talked about 2%, we actually wrote it as a fraction as 2 over 100. You know, so 2 for every 100, 2%. And in this case here, we don't know the percent, so we're trying to solve for the percent. So it's going to be x over 100 is equal to 700 over 20,000. Now, to make this a little bit easier, we could go ahead and we're going to divide here by the, hold on a second. Okay, so we're just going to go ahead and divide the 700 by 20,000, okay? So if you go ahead and do that on your calculator, you will see 0.035, okay? That comes out. So then, I mean, if you just looked at it this way, you could say, I'm going to continue down here because I don't have a lot of room. X over 100 equals 0.035. I could multiply this by 100 over here to get X. And then if I multiply this by 100, I would end up with 3.5%. Okay. And maybe some of you could actually see that I would go over 1/2. Because I want to know percent, and percent goes to the hundredths place, okay? And then beyond that is going to be a, you know, a portion of a percent. So in this case, I have 3.5%, okay? So 70 out of 20,000 equals 3.5%. So that was the gain, the percentage gain, was 3.5%, which, I mean, isn't bad, isn't a bad percent. I mean, you don't make that much by putting your money in a savings account in a bank, so still better than a bank. Okay, well, B here asks, it says that based on the gains and losses on their investment during this 5-year period, over what period of time was their investment not doing well? So we can go back and look at that, and we can see very clearly 2009, a couple of things happened here in 2009. There was this loss, okay, loss of $607.29, and if we go back here, we could look at what happened. There was a, you know, a loss there of on their investment. There's two losses here. There was a loss during the first half of the year, and then a loss during the second half of the year, and they had to withdraw money, okay? That's the only time they actually withdrew money was during 2009. To continue here, it asks you, well, what factors might contribute to this? Well, like we had been talked about before, and maybe you you guys and girls have heard on the news, but I mean, the economy moves up and down. I mean, sometimes things aren't going so well. Sometimes things are going better. It might have been a little downturn in the economy. They might have had some extra expenses that they need to withdraw that money for. Again, like I had said before, not a really good idea when you're talking about, you know, a child's college investment, something you want to just keep your hands off as a parent, okay? But yeah, there could have been many factors, you know, poor economy. I'm not sure exactly what you're going to write here, but just, you know, 2009 was the bad year where the investment was not doing well. Factors could have been the economy, etc. Okay. Now, C, it says, in math class, Jaheim and Frank were working on finding the total amount of the investment after 5 years. Okay. We're working on finding the total amount of the investment after 5 years. As a final step, Jaheim subtracted 150 for administrative fees from the balance he arrived at after adding in all the deposits and subtracting out the one withdrawal and broker's fee. For every semi-annual statement, Frank subtracted $15 from the account balance for the administrative fee. Both boys arrived at the same ending 5-year balance. How is this possible? Okay. Because there's not always, you know, one best way. But now Jaheim, he is actually looking at it after it happened. Okay, well, we all are. We're looking at all of this. We're filling in this register. This is not very realistic, because what you try to do is you try to fill in your register one, you know, every time you get a statement, okay? So after you get that first 6-month statement, you go to your register, you enter your expenses, you enter your income, and then you come up with your balance at that ending period, okay? Now, what Jaheim has done is he has actually just taken, you know, the $15 administrative fees, and he's just multiplied that by 10, okay, because there were 10 separate statements, and that's where he arrived at that $150 number. So he went ahead and just took that off right at the end, okay? So he took it all off at one time, and then he went ahead and just subtracted out that broker's fee as well, okay? So, I mean, there are different ways to do this problem, but honestly, realistically, when you're doing this regularly, you would do this at the end of every 6-month period. As soon as you got your statement, you would want to go ahead and fill in your register. Okay, I'd like to see what you can do with D on your own. So if you would go ahead, I'll read it for you here. I'd like you to, and again, it's a prediction, so there's no absolute magic to it, but when you're looking at something like this and you're trying to predict how your investment will perform in the future, which is a very difficult thing to do, all you have is the past. You have past information. So what you need to do is go ahead and look at the register and just take a look at how this investment has been performing over the last several periods or few periods to predict. But anyway, let me read this for you here. So based on the past statements, I didn't want to do that. Based on the past statements, okay, like I just mentioned, for their investment account, predict what activity you might expect. You might expect to see on Adrien and Justin's January to June 2013 account statement. Then record it in the register to arrive at the balance as of June 30th. 2013. Okay, so go ahead and look at those statements, the last few that we have information for, and go ahead and predict what you think will happen in the January to June account statement. Just a general, how much will it go up? How much will it go down? And then come on back and see what I wrote. Okay, so when I went back and looked at those last few periods, I noticed that the gains have been about $900. So if we go back and look, they had to get even over here with their gains, about $900 there, a little bit over $900 here, another gain of $942, $909. So I think it's pretty safe to say about $900. If I were to average all those out, it'd be a little bit over $900. So I would say even after the administration fee of $15, I would still predict about a $900 gain, and then recording it, that would be $900 plus what was it the last entry right here. If I added $900 to this, this right here, I'll go do that and come on back. And that's going to be about a balance, about $29,020. And this is not exact, $29,020. That's approximately, okay, that's what I would predict anyway. A gain right here of about $900. And then, of course, my fee of $15. But I'm saying this is going to be about a net. That's going to include that $15 fee as well. Okay? Now, E asks us here, using the answer from Part D, if their daughter's college bill is due in September 2013, how much money do you estimate will be in their investment account by the end of August 2013 before the college bill is paid? Okay, so how much is going to be in there by August? Because we are looking right now, we are saying that June of 2013, this would be, you know, this goes up to June of 2013. Okay, that's when this one ends. All right, so if we have $29,020 in June, how much is that going to be? How much will we have about August? Okay, so we're looking at another 2 months. So if you want to go ahead and do a little figuring, come on back with the prediction. What do you predict? And you can use my number here to start off with, $29,020. How much will that grow to by August based on the trends here? Okay, so I just went back and I looked, and if I'm, you know, I'm saying there's about $900 per six-month period she's been averaging, I'm going to go ahead and just, you know, divide 900 by six, and I'm going to get about an average of about $150 per month gain. And if I multiply that by 2 months, because that I'm going from June to July, July to August, I'm going to have another net gain of about $300. So if I go ahead and add that $300 to what I have right here, already, we're ending up with what, $29,320. So $29,320 approximately. Okay, and these are all predictions, but that's about where I predict they will be by August. So hopefully that will be enough money for them by that time. Okay, so in this final exercise before we close up this very long lesson, your task is to take the ending balance. The ending balance has been given to you, okay? And you have all the transaction amounts, okay? So you have all the transaction amounts. Your mission is to come up with the beginning balance, okay? This is what we want you to come up with. I want you to come up with. Not very tricky once you get it. But I'm going to let you go and do it yourself, see what you can come up with, see if you can find out the correct strategy. All right, there's a very, very powerful strategy. And, well, its name is, as you can imagine, its name is Working Backwards. Okay, and let me see if you can get to there. So go ahead and pause this presentation and see what you can do, and come on back and check it. Okay, so hopefully you came to this, got to this answer here, 80102 as the beginning balance, and you can yell out Eureka or Yippee Hooray if that did indeed happen. And when you're working backwards, hopefully you noticed, or you did figure out, you know, as you're moving from beginning to end, okay, payments are subtracted, okay, and deposits are added. Now, if you're going to work backwards, you're going to do just the opposite, okay? So when you were working backwards, for example, you had your ending balance of $525.55. Now your payment of $65.48, because you were working backwards, you would have added, okay? So you would have done $525.55, added back $65.48, and you would have ended up with $591.03, okay? And that's what ended up to be right there. Okay, now, then moving again, doing the same exact thing over here, when you had your $150 deposit, which was originally an addition when you're moving the correct way from beginning balance to ending balance, now you had to actually subtract that away. So you went ahead and did 591.03, subtracted away 150.